Hi guys, I'm going to show you a terrific technique to incorporate in our trigonometry. Now, we're doing bearings over here, and you've heard me say in the past that a problem well drawn is a problem half solved. And over here, we've drawn that problem. Let me just go through it because there's a lot of words, and this is the diagram for it. So it's drawn pretty well, I must say. Now, the bearing of Q right over here, from is where we put the crosshairs. Here's the crosshairs. Crosshairs, vertical, horizontal, north, east, south, and west. Crosshairs go here because it's from P. So the question says the bearing of Q from P is 56 degrees true north. When you see a T, that means true north. And we know that R is due east. Now R is due east of Q, right, from there. So due east means if we put a crosshair there, it's exactly perpendicular or at right angles across that way to R. Now that's the drawing. Now, our task and our mission is to work out the size of the angle PQR. Let's have a look at the diagram. PQR, we're looking for the angle in there. How do we do this? Well, I'm going to incorporate something really ingenious. What we're going to do here is we're going to show you a technique whereby you can solve these. Now, this is the type of question you often get in exams and in tests, and they're kind of twisted and tricky in these type of questions. So here's the solution. What we do, we're going to go to another topic. It's called geometry. We're going to take some techniques from there, bring them and incorporate them here, and then be able to solve this question easily and effectively. Now, what techniques can we borrow from geometry? Well, check this out. We have a bearing here, 56 degrees going across there, right? Now, in here, we don't know what the angle is. That's our outcome, isn't it? So you look at it and you say, what do I have? Well, since I have this angle here, what if we incorporate and borrow from geometry another line that goes vertically through here? What if we did that? Let me just draw a little rough line here. I'm just going to put it in here. What if we put a vertical line just a straight line through there, parallel to this line here. Now, I know that looks rough, but let's assume it's a perfect right angle. In fact, let me just put this here as a right angle, right in there. Okay, we have a vertical line going through there. It's not perfect, but it's a vertical line. Well, if we have a line through here, we've just introduced it, and it's free, we can do that. And we have another vertical line here, then we have two parallel lines. Now that's good news for geometry because you know when we have two parallel lines and there's a line cutting through it, i.e. PQ, there's a line cutting through it, we can kind of use angle systems, can't we? Like alternate, corresponding, that kind of stuff, right? Co-interior, we can use that to find out what this angle in total is. Now we've already solved part of this problem. By introducing a vertical line, we already know this side is 90 degrees, right angle. So we've got that part. All we need to do is find what's happening in there. Because what are we looking for? What's our outcome? We are focusing on PQR, that total angle. And part of it, we have it. It's the right angle. Well, let's have a look at the geometry now. We have vertical line here, two parallel lines. And we can use, well, we know we got 56 degrees here. So I'm wondering, what would this angle in here be? Let me just mark it out in red. What would that be if we know that these two lines are parallel and we got 56? I wonder whether you can see, whether you can recognize that we have an alternate situation here. Remember, alternate angles are equal. Why? Because we have parallel lines. And what system do we look for? We look for a Z. Well, if you turn your head on the side, it's kind of like a Z like that. There's the 56, and we know that this angle in there is also 56 degrees. Whoa, isn't that cool? We just brought in some geometry into it. 56, 56. Now, if we asked ourselves, how do we find angle PQR? Well, we got the 56 in there, and we've got the right angle in there. So we just write it out, add them together, and we have our angle PQR. So let's just write it up. Now, this line we just introduced is the first step that we did, right? So we introduce line that is parallel, those two lines mean parallel, parallel to north-south. So there it is, parallel to north south, yeah? So that gives us two parallel lines, which means we can use angle systems from geometry. And what we did is we worked out alternate angles. So let's write that down. Alternate, which means the angle in here, right there, is equal to also 56 degrees, yeah? Because they're alternate. Okay, we've got the 56. Now on this side, because we introduced the vertical line, and we know that R is east, which means it's at right angles, that means this here is at right angles to that line we just introduced, isn't it? So we know that part there is 90 degrees. So that means, because it's going out that way, easterly, east, we know that angle is 90 degrees. Which means we can add the two angles now. So 56 plus 90 is going to give us the angle PQR. So let's put that in official writing. So angle PQR, let me point it out, PQR adds up the two angles of right in there is 56 degrees plus in orange the right angle 90 degrees, and that gives us a grand total angle PQR, the whole thing all the way across, which is our outcome, 56 plus 90 on the calculator.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.